Hello everyone, this is the Physics Gurus from your favorite YouTube channel, the Physics Gurus. So here we go, because the papers are coming at the end of the July for the mini exam series. So now there will be many more solutions related with the MCQs, related with the O-levels and IGCSE. So here is the solution related with the October-November 2020 variant 1-1. So here we go, we will start it without any delay. So the paper which we will use, so here is my pen. So I have set my pen, okay, that is fine. So question number one. Now in question number one, he is saying that a heavy nail is fixed firmly to a wall. It is pulled by a string at an angle of 40 degree to the vertical. The nail does not move. It means that system is in equilibrium. So it means that the forces are balanced. So resultant force is equal to zero. So you have learned from the vector diagram that whenever there is a closed triangle, then that will show that the resultant force is zero. The weight will act in the downward direction. So in this diagram, the force of tension will act in the upward direction. So in this diagram, we have to observe, okay, weight is acting in downward direction, tension is acting in upward direction. So this is incorrect because tension is acting in downward direction. This is incorrect because force of tension is acting in downward direction. So we have to see that in which diagram the force of tension is acting in upward direction. So whether the option A or whether the option C, but in which diagram there is a closed triangle. So option A will be the correct option, because in option A, the diagram will show a closed triangle, this arrow sign, and this arrow sign, which show that the resultant force is zero. The object is at its equilibrium. Second question, a car began to move its speed up until it reaches a constant speed. He is not saying that it is raised at the constant velocity. So it will continue to travel at this constant speed for the rest of the journey. So what will happen to the acceleration and what will happen to the velocity during the journey? Because it speed ups. So it means that there is change in acceleration and it has a constant speed. It means that there is change in the direction as well. So always remember that acceleration is due to change in velocity and velocity is due to change in direction. So option A is the correct option. Now this is an interesting question. Question number three. What is given? The mass is given, the acceleration is given, frictional force is given, and he is saying that what is the driving force. So what we will do, we will apply the formula F minus F equal to ma. So we are required to calculate F. That is equal to F plus ma, and then we will get 1200 and plus 800 into 2.5, and then when we will solve this, we will get answer equal to 3200 newton. So the correct answer is 3200 newton. Question number four. A parachutist falls at a steady speed, opens their parachute. Now whenever the parachute will open our parachute, always remember that the surface area will increase, so the resultant force will act in upper direction because the air resistance is more and the weight which is acting will not change. But the direction of the acceleration will always in which direction? So resultant force will be in upper direction and acceleration is always x in the direction in which the force acts. The force will act in upper direction. So the correct answer is option D, because the resultant force due to the increased surface area will act in the upper direction. The air resistance will be more and the resultant force will be direction having in upper direction. Question number five. So some gas is trapped in a cylinder and is compressed. By compressing and stretching, there is change in density, there is change in pressure, there is change in volume. but mass will not change because neither the gas particles are entering into the container nor they are leaving. So the option B is the correct option for question number 5. For question number 6, an interesting question that is going to be checked the capability of a student with respect to the units. So a block is hung on a spring balance. The marker inside the balance is pulled down by the block. What can the position of the marker be used to determine? So we will look that the mass as the option. Mass is in kg. The mass is in newton, not possible. The moment as unit newton meter, not possible. The weight should be in newton, not possible. So the option A is the correct option. An electrical charged plastic ball is at rest. So there will be the weight which will act in the downward direction. And there is an electrical field as well. So for question number 7, the electric and gravitational types of the field will be available around the charge, because if it is a positive charge, then the electric field will act moving away, and if it is a negative charge, then the electric field will move towards the charge. So option B is the correct option. For question number 8, which statement about the mass and the weight is correct? Mass is a scientific term. No, the mass of an object on Earth is 10 times its weight. No, the weight is a scalar quantity. No, because weight is a vector quantity. Weight is a force of gravity pull on a mass. So for question number 8, the correct option will be option D. For question number 9, a very simple question. I think that the most easiest question in this paper so far. So density is the mass over volume. So option B is the valid option. For question number 10, a length of thread is attached to a lamina at point P as shown in the diagram. The lamina is free to rotate about point Q. The force of tension in the thread is F. What is the moment? Now the definition of the moment, that is the product of the force and the perpendicular distance from pivot. Now what is the perpendicular distance from pivot? The force is F. Okay, that is fine. But now this is a point and this is the distance which will make the angle of 90 degree with the line of action of the force. So for question number 10, the correct option is F into Y. Now we will move to question number 11. For question number 11, that which list contains only quantities that can be changed by the force? Mass can never change by the force. Another straightforward question. So option D, shape, velocity and volume can be changed by a force. One of the repeated question. So he is saying that which point marks the limit of proportionality? The limit of proportionality is till which point in the graph of the load extension where line is a straight. So after that, there is a curve in the upper direction. It means that by increasing the load, there will be more extension. So point B is the valid answer. For question number 13, a manometer is used to measure the gas pressure. So it means that from the diagram, we can observe that atmospheric pressure is more as compared to the gas pressure. And gas pressure we can calculate by using the height, the difference of the height. So rho gh will be the pressure related with the gas. So the air pressure is more and the gas pressure is less. So correct option is option A. Question number 14, that there is a current in a resistor, which energy changes will take place? Resistor will convert electrical energy into heat energy, and the alternate for the heat energy is the internal energy. So the option B is the correct option for question number 14. Now question number 15, the repeated question from the past paper, that a ball is dropped from a height as shown, ignoring the effect of air resistance. So there is no change in the atmosphere related with the heat energy. So which statement about the energy of the ball is correct? So the law of conservation of energy said that at all points, the energy will remain same. So option A is the correct option. Now, question number 16, that which one following is the not the renewable energy source? So, difference between the renewable and not renewable energy source. Renewable energy source which will not run out and non-renewable energy source which will run out. So, solar energy can reuse, hydroelectric regenerated, wind turbine regenerated. But once we will use the nuclear power, nuclear energy, then we can't get them back. So, for question number 16, option D is the valid option. Now, question number 17, he is saying that the table shows some data from a high jump competition. Which athlete jumps the highest? So, very simple. E equal to mgh. And now we will calculate the h by using the formula E over mg. So, energy is 33 over 600, then 1660 over 700 mg and 800 and then 900. So, this is equal to 2.2. The answer related with this is 2.2. So, the answer related with this will be 2.3, then 2.2, then again 2.0. So, which one is the highest distance traveled? Is the 2.3? So, option B is the valid option. So, guys, the next question, another repeated question. A workman rolls a barrel of the weight of 2000 Newton on a plank of the length this and 0.8 meter. What is the work done barrel against gravity? Against gravity ka matlab hoga that the work done that is equal to mgh. So the value of the mg is given that is 2000 and the height is given 0.8. So the correct answer is 1600 joule. So that is the repeated question. Now the question number 19, data for a new question that has been never asked in the previous papers. The data for the three type of electricity generations are shown in the diagram. So now he is saying that which one is the least efficient and which one is the most efficient. So in order to calculate that, we have to calculate the efficiency of the particular source which is given. So the wastage of energy is given. So output energy, what will be the output energy? 200. So from here the output will be 40 and the output will be 9.0. Now we will calculate the efficiency. Efficiency is output over input multiplied by 100. So 40 over 200 and then multiply by 100, 9 over 10 and then multiply by 100. So multiply by 100, multiply by 100. So we will get the answer for this. 40% for oil, it is 40% efficient. For nuclear energy, it is 20% efficient. And hydroelectric power is 90% efficient. So for question number 19, the least efficient is the nuclear and the most efficient is the hydroelectric. So option C is the valid option. So this question contains a two-step calculation. For question number 20, an instructor in a physics book states that divide the length between two marks of the glass tube into 100 equal parts. So that is used for the calibration of the thermometer. Whenever we will divide the lower and the upper limit into equal graduation, it means that we are calibrating that particular device. What is the unit of the heat capacity? Formula for the heat capacity is that is equal to E over delta theta. So, joule per degree centigrade. So, for question number 21, the option C is the valid option. Now, question number 22. A block of aluminium is heated. So what will happen to the kinetic energy and what will happen to the potential energy? Because we are providing the heat energy, so kinetic energy will also increase as well as the potential energy will also increase. So for question number 23, which statement about the melting of ice and the boiling of water will take place is correct? So melting and boiling will take place at a constant temperature. And that particular state are related with the latent heat, the hidden heat. So the correct option will that option C, that the both processes involve the absorption of the latent heat. Now another question related with the melting and the boiling. The melting point is minus 17 and the boiling point is 117. So it means that if the temperature is greater than minus 17 and less than 117, that will be the state of the liquid. So now what will happen in this? The liquid, and the liquid will be the correct answer, because minus 10 is the greater temperature and the dead substance will start melting. So it means that is in the form of the liquid, and on the other side it hasn't reached its boiling point, which is 117. Question number 25. For question number 25, that the smoke particle is seen move randomly haphazard movement when suspended in the air particle. Which statement explain why Z move randomly? So because the air particles will strike the particle C from different directions, so it has a random direction. So for question number 25, option C is the valid option. Now for question number 26, electromagnetic wave has a speed of 3 into 10 to the power 8 and wavelength is this. Frequency is required. Frequency f dot is equal to v over lambda. So it is 3 into 10 to the power 8 divided by 0.1. So you will get answer option D. Now for this question, we have to draw the diagrams, because without completing the diagram, we can't say that which option is the correct. So R will be at this point, Q will be at same distance, P will be at same distance. So now you can see that the ray diagram is not, the ray from I is not cutting the mirror, while for Q, the ray is cutting the mirror and reach towards I. It is a straight line. So I don't have right now scale with me. So it will also reach towards I. It means that we can observe P, we can observe Q, but we can't see R. So for question number 27, option B is the correct option. Question number 28, a ray of light is incident on water to air surface. So ray is going from more denser medium to more to less denser medium. So it means that when the ray of light will emerge out into the water, it will bend away from normal. So in that case, angle of incidence will be less and angle of refraction will be more. So now let's see, according to that, which option is the correct option. It travel into the air with an angle of refraction greater than theta. Yep, this is the correct answer. If the angle of incidence is 20, then angle of refraction will be maybe 30-35. Question number 29. So for question number 29, we have to observe that whenever the light ray will pass through the center, it will go straight. So it means option A is the invalid, option D is the invalid, because they are bending at this point, at this particular point, and it will become parallel. Now whenever the slanting ray, now this diagram shows that they are passing through the F. Always remember that whenever the parallel light ray will pass through the lens, then it will pass through F. So it means that this option is the incorrect. These are the coming in the slanting angle. So option C is the correct option. Which description of the sound wave is the correct? Longitudinal electromagnetic wave, no. Transverse and electromagnetic wave, no. Particle parallel. So this one is related with the definition of the longitudinal wave. That in the longitudinal wave, the particle will move parallel in the direction of the movement of the particles. So option C is the valid option. So question number 31, that where does the sound travel fastest? Obviously, sound will travel fastest in solids, because the particles are tightly packed. In vacuum, the sound will not travel at all. A bar magnet is placed in a hollow or iron cylinder. The diagram shows the magnetic field pattern. So what is the cause of the field inside the cylinder wall? Electromagnetic generation, no possibility of the electromagnetic waves. electromagnetic induction, no. Electrostatic induction, these are not the charges, but this is a magnetic induction. So option D is the valid option. For question number 33, a polythene rod is brought near to the stream of the water from a metal tap which has an earth wire. The tap is an electrical conductor. Now, this is a very important key point, that the tap is an electrical conductor. So the water moved towards the rod as shown. It means that there is a bending whenever the rod and the water are charged. So it means that option A is the valid option. For question number 34, now this question is saying that a negative charge is placed at a point where electric field is vertically upward. Now electric field is always having two plates. Number one is positive plate, number two is negative plate. And electric field is always having the direction from positive towards the negative. Now they are saying that an electron is placed between this region. Electron contains negative charge, so the force on the electron will be in the vertically downward direction. So option B is the valid option. So question number 35, in the circuit shown, the resistance of resistor Y is 4 times greater than the resistor X. What is the difference between VY, this one, and this one? So let's suppose that it has a resistance of 2 ohm. So 4 times will that 8 ohm. So there will be 8 volt dropped, and there will be 2 volt dropped at this point. So 8 minus 2 will give you 6 volt. So option C is the valid option. Question number 36. Two identical resistors connected in parallel have a total resistance of 4 ohm. It means that if we will consider the two resistors, then their equivalent resistance was 4.0 ohm. It means that this resistance was having 8.0 ohm and this was also having 8.0 ohm. Now he is saying that when they are connected the same resistance in series, then what is the total resistance? So 8.0 plus 8.0 will give you 16 ohm. Now third last question. Three identical lamps are having 3 ammeter as connected. So I1 will be always greater because it is emerging out from the cell or the battery. Now I2 contain single lamp and I3 contain double lamp. So the double lamp are connected in series, so there will be more resistance. It means that I1 is having the greatest strength, then I2 and then I3. I3 have the least strength. So option D is the valid option. And question number 38, this is really the most technical question in this paper. So what we will do, we will consider the conditions. So when we will consider this 6000 ohm and the other one is the 2000 ohm, he is saying at which condition the LDR will have the 2 volt. So I will use these values and then I will calculate the V2. Let's see what will be the answer for this. If I will use these techniques, these calculations, then I will get the value of V2 that is equal to 6 into 2000 divided by 8000. So this is a formula to calculate the PD. So 12000 divided by 8000. So 1.5. So it means that it is not the correct option. So now we will use the value which are given at the values 1000 and the other one. 1000 ohm means that the room is warm and the other value is the room is, the light is bright. So 500 ohm. Again we will apply the same formula. So for this one we will calculate V2. So 6 into 500 and divided by 1500. So we will get 3000 upon 1500. So we will get 2.0 volts. So it means that the lamp should be brighter. The brightness of the bulb, it will be bright and the room will be warm. So which option is this one? That in a warm room, yes, warm room for 1000. And for the brighter light. So option C is the valid option. 39 kilowatt hour. So which equation is the correct equation? Power should be power that is equal to energy over time, and energy that is equal to power into time. So power should be in kilowatt. Kilowatt means that we will divide it by 1000. But here the formula which we will use, VIT. Because direct the power is not given, but we can calculate the power VI. From VI we will calculate the power and divide it by 1000. And time should be in hours because of this. Kilowatt hour. This is a large unit of the consumption of the electricity. So the valid option is the option D. Now this question for the radioactivity. He is saying that 0.016, and then after how much time the quantity will left 0.0020 kg. So we will start from 0.016, we will make it half, 0.008, 1 half life, again 0.004, 2 half life, then again 0.002. So from moving 0.016 up to 0.002, there will be 3 half-lives. And 1 half-life contains 7 years. So 3 half-life means that there are 21 years. So this is the correct option. So see you next time with more solutions. Take care. Bye-bye.